Hello everyone! Today, I'm going to show you how to use position to anchor Nodon. With a good understanding of this, you can create a simple navigation system or even make a blue AI. I also have other GPT tutorials on my YouTube channel and stream GPT games weekly. Please subscribe if you haven't! For this tutorial, I will cover the basics of position to anchor Nodon and how to create a simple navigation system. So what is position to anchor Nodon? It is a Nodon that can change the position into the anchor. The inputs of the Nodon are horizontal and vertical positions, and these can be any values. The output is an anchor from negative 180 to 180. But how are the two positions translated into the anchor? Let's look at this diagram together. There are horizontal and vertical axes, or x and y respectively. How we read the anchor is that in the first quadrant, the anchor is from 0 to 90. In the second quadrant, the anchor is from 90 to 180. However, if we read the anchor at the bottom, the anchor will be a negative value. Let's learn about input-output of position to anchor Nodon by going through a few examples together. Currently, both horizontal and vertical have 0 values, so the output will be 0. After I have increased the horizontal position, the output will still be 0. Let's restart this. If I increase the value on vertical axis instead, the output will be 90. That is because the anchor here is 90. Decreasing the vertical position gives the output of negative 90, and what about decreasing the horizontal position? We will get 180 instead. Let's look at more examples. From here, when I move up, I will get some positive angles. For example here, the angle is around 38.5. However, if I start moving downwards, I will get negative angles. And here, I can get negative 142. With this, I hope you understand how position to anchor Nodon works. It changes horizontal position or X and vertical position or Y into an anchor. Let's go take a look at an example. We are going to implement a simple navigation system. This person is trying to find a fluff ball, but no matter how long he has walked, he cannot find the fluff ball. So we are going to add an arrow to tell him where the fluff ball actually is. Here on the programming screen, I have a person Nodon with all the inputs and a camera attached to it. I also have a fluff ball here, which... Now we are going to implement the navigation system. First of all, we need to know the location of both. So I'm going to attach location sensors to both characters. Next, we need to add an arrow on top of the person Nodon. I'm going to use a free slide connector to move the arrow instead of attaching it to the person Nodon because of two reasons. First, the arrow will not affect the person Nodon's physics. Second, the arrow will not rotate when the person rotates. And to use the free slide connector, I'm adding a base box. Remove all the properties and make sure that it is located at 000 or the origin. Then add a free slide connector on its upper part. Attach the arrow fancy object to it. Go to the settings and make sure that it is visible and movable. The connection point is from Y negative to Y positive. We also have to send the location of the person Nodon to free slide connector input. Now we can see that there is an arrow on top of the person Nodon when he walks. However, the arrow does not rotate yet. We need to add a Y hinge connector so that it can rotate. Remove the current connection between the free slide connector and the arrow. Add a box with properties movable only. Add a Y hinge connector. Make sure that it can rotate from negative 180 to 180. Now we have to compute how much the arrow has to rotate. We have locations of both objects. So, I'm going to use position to anchor Nodon. Basically, I have to compute this angle. Adding a position to anchor Nodon. The orthogonal input is the difference between z coordinates of both characters. While the vertical input is the difference between x coordinates of both characters. Do note that I use the present coordinate minus the probable coordinate and not the other way around. Then, send the output of this position to anchor Nodon to Y hinge connector. With this, our person Nodon can finally find the buffer. Yeah! And that's it for today's tutorial. See you all soon! Don't forget to check my other tutorials such as anchor to position Nodon and boo tutorials. And bye bye!